I caption what I'm about to tell you people, a nation on the brink of collapse. It's a press statement delivered by me today. Gentlemen of the press, may I first thank once again the media for your heroic support during my over one month illegal detention in the state gallows, for exercising my right to free speech and freedom of association. I thank you all for all the campaign agitation by most of you. And we continue to express my gratitude to the members of the media. We are still in court with the DSS, where I'm seeking damages in the tune of 300 million for this illegal detention, and also to nullify that illegal detention. And I'm still grappling with some health challenges that happened to me while I was in detention. Fellow countrymen, democracy and rule of law are under siege in our country today. The parliament, which is populated by the real representative of the people, is under attack, awaiting decapitation like in our nation's darkest ages of 1984. There is insurrection in the land. Agitation for secession are unfortunately increasing every day, and citizens are not seeing any clear-cut consumer action by the government to bring them under control, while assaulting the people and giving every section a sense of belonging. This latest ongoing and baseless criminal charges preferred against the Senate President, Dr. Bukola Saraki, and the Deputy Senate President, Ike Ekweremadu, is obviously to get the men out of the way to enable a violent takeover of the leadership of the Senate. The plot is to try both men close to the vacation of judges of the City High Court and remind them in Kuje prison, pending the hearing of the bail application after the 2 months vacation, thereby allowing the enemies of democracy time to effect leadership change in the parliament. They have planned to invade this parliament if the Senate President is detained in Kuje, and with 39 senators, they will announce a takeover, just like they did in Kogi State. Senator Saraki was not a presiding officer of the 7th Senate. Both Senator Saraki and Senator Ekweremadu were never invited by the police for interrogation, and their statements were not obtained. Shockingly, there is an affidavit of completion of investigation filed in court. One wonders how a matter has been fully investigated, and people who were not invited because the police did not consider them worthy for invitation are now the ones being charged. Section 3791A and IV of the Administration of Criminal Justice Act 2015 states that for a competent charge to be filed, it shall contain copies of statement of defendant who filed that cock and bull charge. Like the ongoing Code of Conduct tribunal trial, Senator Bukola Saraki is once again not invited for questioning. Also, like in the Code of Conduct trial, was his non-invitation, not because the essence of the trial is to convict him in the court of public opinion and not the court of law. It is clear that the executive and persons highly placed in the ruling party have not overcome the shock of Senator Saraki's emergence in the free democratic process as Senate President. Men must learn to accept defeat. The impunity they are willing to deploy in their failed attempt to remove him is unprecedented. Men stood up and challenged Hitler. Men stood up and challenged Mobutu Sese Seko. Idi Amin was opposed. Even our own Abacha was effectively opposed. Therefore, Nigerians have in 2015 election voted out impunity, and we shall fight it to ensure it does not rear its ugly head anywhere again. I speak as a victim of the Buhari government's growing culture of impunity and intolerance to dissent and free speech. As you're already aware, I was detained for over 1 month without access to lawyer, food, water, anything, and without being told what is my offense, other than I express my right to free speech. We shall continue to speak up against impunity. In the days ahead, we will mobilize to resist this impunity at all levels and defend the parliament. The executive should know that the parliament has its own constitutional powers with which it can protect itself, and it will be counterproductive. If the desire of the Senate for harmonious working relationships with the executive is taken for granted, the expectation of indeed all Nigerians is for all hands to be on deck to steer the ship of our nation for this brink of collapse. Yet persons trusted with this responsibility are busy engaging in needless political wars. The economic problems are increasing. The song of disunity is rising. What executive should send to the parliament is executive bills to solve the growing unemployment and not judicial summons to send them to jail when they were not party to the alleged offense. Time has come for the parliament to wield all its powers to save constitutional democracy. Nigerian youth shall stand with the parliament in any action it takes to save the institutional power democracy. Nigerians must rise up to this occasion, like we have all in times of need done. This is a clarion call. We may not be the victim, you may not be the victim today, but if you keep quiet, it will arrive at your doorstep. I have become a victim, and I don't want to be another victim again. Manipulating the judiciary just to achieve goals that we are not achieved in the floor of the parliament is not good for our democracy. And the court have heard so. You are aware of the ruling of Justice Kolawole of the Federal High Court that the issue of Senate through another is purely a domestic affair of the parliament. So, Nigeria is a democracy, and the sacrosanct principle of separation of powers must be respected and defended.